Coach, thanks for checking in with us from down there in Ocilla. Last season, I know you didn't make it to the last game of the year, but it was a great run for you, another double-digit win season. The lessons from 2022 that you've brought with you to the 23 season would be what?
I don't know if there's any lessons necessarily. We would have liked to finish that game and had the changes we made in the second half for the first half, so we didn't get behind so much at the start of it. But I don't know if there's any, necessarily lessons or anything like that, but we just got to start games better.
Mm-hmm.
You've been so successful at Irwin the past 3 years. Heading into your fourth season, how is practice this year? Are you implementing anything new, or is it same old, same old? Give us a recap of spring and summer ball so far.
Pretty much the same old, same old. We're going to do what we do. It's just what we do through our younger programs and carry it on up to here. So we're going to do what we do and just try to get better at it and all that. Practice has been great so far. It has been different for me, obviously. This will be the first year I haven't had one of my youngins either as a manager or playing for me for a really long time. Wow. Starting with my oldest son, Tyler, then to Cody, who just finished up last year. So it is different. Every once in a while I look around, try to find one of them, and they're not to be found. And so that makes it a little bit different. But practices have been going great. Coaches have been going well, and we've had a lot of participation. We got right around 80 some kids out right now.
Wow.
And so I've been real happy.
Region 1 D1 is where you are with this go round after they split up the old Region 1. So Region 1 D1, you're in with Brooks, you're in with Pelham, you're in with Bacon, which means that you've got to find a lot of non-region games. When you look at your schedule here in 23, what do you see about the 10 games on the schedule?
Man, I'd like to fire the guy that made the schedule. Man, let me tell you, we got a good one, and obviously it'll just be the flip side of last year's schedule. The one plus every time I look at it though is I don't have to go to Rockmart. That's the one plus for sure. That was a long drive. We got up there and even though we won, it was a long trip back.
Mm-hmm.
It was a long trip back. That's why it was just a long time. And so I'm glad they have to make that trip this year and not us. But obviously Swainsboro's and the team up north and early counties and all them on there, we've got a pretty good schedule.
Irwin's always loaded with talent, Coach. Tell me about some of your playmakers getting offers in this offseason, and then, of course, a kid on your team that deserves an offer.
Well, we got Shane Marshall, who's running back. He's gotten a couple offers and gotten some looks, and he is definitely a kid that they should be looking at. He's just a great kid and a great running back, and if people would see how he works, they would know why he's getting the offers that he's getting. He deserves everything that he gets because he works hard for it. Another guy is Michael Joyner. He defensive lineman for us. He'll be returning. He's played for he started for us the last couple of years. Another guy that has really he's one of them stories you like to talk about because I ain't gonna lie. When he first started with us, I wasn't sure if me or him was going to make it. But then he bought in, did all the things he was supposed to do. And now he's one of them guys I like to be around. I want him around. I want kids to see what he's doing because he's bought in completely, works out hard, does all the things he's supposed to do. Now he's one of our team leaders. And so great guy. And he's gotten a few offers and I'm really proud of what he's doing. Brody Suggs is another guy, plays tight end for us. A lot of people looking at him again, just, all these guys have that same common thread. They deserve what they're getting because they're working for it. They go out, they put in extra time. They don't just do it during our practice time, but they do it during their time and all that kind of stuff. And you said something about a guy that probably deserves one. That's probably Jakeen Thomas. Plays DB for us. Started last year, did really good for us, but he was overshadowed by some of the names that we had back there in the secondary last year with Bo Payne and Malachi Haddon and some of those guys. And so now it's kind of his show. He's the one returning DB we got. And man, he's been a really good leader for us this offseason. Really fast, really worked on his craft, done really good at some camps that we've been to. And I'm just waiting for somebody else to notice that and give him an offer.
One of your first non-region games traditionally is against the team up north. And it, right. If someone has never seen this game, can I mention the school in your interview? Can I mention the name of the school?
Yeah, you can.
Okay. It's when Irwin plays Fitzgerald. I just wanted to make sure. So when Irwin plays Fitzgerald, if you've never gone to see this game, go see this game. I mean, literally, underline, exclamate, italicized, boldface. But it's part of the fabric of what athletics means down there in South Georgia. For someone who has never been to an Irwin County game, has never been to Buddy Nobles, has never been to Ocilla, what does athletics and all the extracurricular stuff mean to everybody there in Irwin County?
Oh, it's huge. It's what you do on Friday night. It's how you get your weekend going. It's all that. Our community, it's obviously not very big, but they love football. They love their athletics. They're not just football. They like it all. But you know, they really like it on Friday nights, going out there and packing stadium. And I'll be honest, our team wouldn't be as good if we did not have the community support that we have from these places. And they get hit up hard. I mean, if you take all that, I think sometimes some of the places in bigger towns don't realize it, but we don't have different businesses to go hit up. We got to go hit up the exact same businesses that we always do to try to fund this program and all that kind of stuff. And so doesn't all the other sport programs we have here, because we only got a handful of businesses here. And they do a great job supporting us. And honestly, our school and our football program wouldn't be what it is without the community support that we get, you know, not just on Friday nights, but throughout the year, trying to get us things, feeding us, doing all the things that people do for us. It's just tremendous.
And there's a lot of tradition that goes on down there. Coach, what's one of your favorite game day traditions that you'd like to share?
Just for me, because I don't go through there. You know, the kids go into our weight room and then they, I have to ask every year because I never can remember the song, but there's a song that they play and then our kids start to come out and break through there. But I'm standing usually on from the field house side of it, looking from the players up into the bleachers, because I don't come out necessarily with them. And just to see them run out and then see the fans get excited, that gives me goosebumps thinking about it right now.
Me too.